Good afternoon, everybody from Manila, the Philippines. We are at the FIBA Basketball World Cup. It's game day three, Group D, and the battle between Egypt and Mexico. Well, these teams had high expectations coming into this FIBA Basketball World Cup, but probably some realistic expectations as well. And as it is, despite having put on some good performances, they've also had some struggles. And here they are in a battle of 0-2 teams and looking to clinch third place in this group. Still a lot at stake when you consider that points do carry over. Of course, these teams will not be going to the quarterfinals. They know that. But it's always important to get as many wins as possible in terms of ranking points for the FIBA World Ranking presented by Nike, also for the prestige of the program. And this is sometimes when you find out what players are all about, how much they're willing to really lay it all out on the line for their countries in these games. They will also be playing in classification games after this. I'm Jeff Taylor, joined by Mike Taylor. And Mike, it's not where they wanted to be, Mexico, but it is where they are.
For both teams, this is about competition.
But here, the national anthems. So for Mexico, Coach Omar Quintero is going to go with Fabian Jaimes, Paul Stoll, Paco Cruz, Gabriel Giron, and Joshua Ibarra, with Gael Bonilla, Jorge Gutierrez, Andriasi, Mendez, Jorge Camacho Gutierrez, and Israel Gutierrez, and Daniel Amigo coming off the bench. And here's Gabriel Giron, who certainly offensively had it going early the other night against Lithuania.
Yeah, he was very impressive offensively. He got his shots going from beyond three. He scored in the paint. He really was driving their offensive production, but that's what a leader does. And here's the other guy. Paco Cruz has been really good in both games. Paco's shown the ability to hit threes, create his own offense. Both of these guys will be really important against this Egypt team here today for Mexico's success.
Gabriel Paco, Fabián Josh. Okay, la pasamos. Reverse, reverse. Kai Gabriel va a tener ventaja. Y si no, sacamos a Paco, okay? Sí. Así como dos pantallas porque van a cambiar. Sí, está bien, si no subimos aquí. O te abres. Hey. Si no funciona, hey, acuérdense, 33, el 2 y el 3, 4 y 5. Aquí, y sube. Y cuando se abre la esquina, se viene y juegan unos 2 y 5, ¿ok? Sale, cabrón. Hey. El inicio es muy importante. Vamos, dale.
Vamos.
Defense. 1, 2, 3.
So we've heard from both Mexico coach and Egypt, and you know, and you got to remember that these teams also, you know, you can finish as the highest ranked African team thinking about the Olympics, or you try to get to the FIBA Olympic qualifying tournament. The same for Mexico.
It's important that you win the right game. You don't have to win every game, but you got to win the right one. And for Egypt, this could be a big step forward. Same thing for Mexico. Again, these are tournament defining competitions, and this is where you have to just be present and be at your best in this challenge. I'm really excited to watch these two teams compete out here today.
Well, if you are the best African team, you qualify for the Olympics, and the second best African team is guaranteed an Olympic qualifying tournament spot, regardless of their final position. So, we are underway, and Egypt against Mexico. Egypt, again, I think they're not even thinking about Olympics qualification, really. They're thinking about playing better, playing hard, and just see where that takes them. And already, we see Ahab Amin driving in. He has been absolutely stunningly good, really, for Egypt.
And that's a great thing for Egypt, but on the Mexican side, you know,
and quick answer for Mexico.
The challenge for Mexico is going to be doing a better job guarding the basketball than they did last game against Lithuania, but that's a great sign for Mexico that Josh Ibarra gets on the board early.
And Patrick Gardner comes out and hits the jumper. Rather inside to a bar, and he goes up and scores.
Two possessions, two plays at the rim, and finishes for Josh Ibarra. Excellent start, but that's a great pick and roll drop off from Paul Stoll.
And inside, and Anas goes up for the dunk.
Again, this Mexican perimeter, the guards need to do a better job of defending the basketball. This is critical for their success in today's game.
Cruz passing it back outside to Giron, who gets in and Amin. Anas going up against Ibarra.
Nice pass from Giron on the baseline. Giron is a very strong low post player. Spun to the baseline, hit Jaimes to the basket, and you see the contact. Late whistle, but correct call on the play.
Jaimes gets it to go. Amin. Now Jaimes, but his pass deflected. That's probably one that Egypt should have intercepted.
Yeah, they got away with one there. You like the idea of being aggressive, but you got to make a high percentage decision. That was a low percentage ball ahead. Fortunately for Mexico, the ball was deflected out of bounds by Egypt.
Farhan out guarding Paco Cruz.
Jaimes attacking the basket well early in the game. Nice finish.
Gardner, and the air ball lands into the hands of Paco Cruz. Perón. Oh, nice rejection from Anas. Zarhat. And I'm undecided. Was that a good foul?
Well, it's a good foul because it's not a shooting foul. He was on the pass, but again, it stops the break. It allows you to set your defense. The issue that we've
terrific
seen.
Terrific block, by the way.
This is outstanding. Heron got in the paint, and Mahmoud with a great block. But the issue right now for Mexico is ball pressure, guarding the ball, which also includes their transition defense. We've seen it the last couple games.
I mean, attempting to feed the ball inside.
And Jeff, that's an excellent matchup for this game today. Paco Cruz against Amin. Two guards who played really well in both games for their team. Players play both ends of the floor, offense, defense, both can score.
Baran Little Renner. He was so good in the opening game for Egypt against Lithuania, attacking the basket, just playing at 100 miles an hour. He was impressive. And then he got late in that game, or I think it was like the late in the third quarter, he had the cramp, and he wasn't the same player. But seeing some signs right now that he's getting back to his best. Oh, stepped out of bounds. I jinxed him.
He had the right idea. Good ball ahead. Again, good pace for Egypt. Just stepped out of bounds, and now we're going to see Assem Marai.
The interesting thing, though, is Assem Marai comes in for Patrick Gardner. I guess what we should say is don't forget Assem Marai, best player for Egypt, okay, coming into this tournament, was outstanding against Lithuania. And then in their vitally important game against Montenegro, he had an allergic reaction to something, and he still doesn't know what it was, and he wasn't able to play. He tried to play, but he couldn't. Here's Ibarra going hard to the basket. That's what he needed to do against Lithuania. He didn't, and now Jaimes comes up and steals the inbound pass. And look at that. Stoll knocks it down, and Egypt get punished for the turnover as Mexico go up 12-11.
Big shot from Paul Stoll. Great pressure defense from Jaimes right there. He's been really active in the early going. And again, another great play from Josh Ibarra.
They have Amin for three. He's just in the zone right now, isn't he?
He is. He's played really well the last two games.
Oh, Paul Stoll goes down, and Assem Marai helps him up. Here's Cruz over to Stoll, back to Cruz, and that is just off. Now a chance to run for Egypt, and they do like to run, especially Amin and Zarhan for the throwdown on the break. Goodness me. Jet propulsion. Ibarra's going out. Israel Gutierrez is coming in. Look at this. And this is how he was playing before he got the cramps.
And if you're Coach Omar Quintero, you want to see your team establish their defense, establish your stoppability, the ability to stop this Egypt team. Right now, Egypt has a great rhythm, pace and transition, and getting anywhere they want to go in the half court.
Jaimes de Heron, the captain, and he steps out of bounds. Yep, good. You can see the camera angle. So you see Assem Marai playing D there. And anyway, before the game, he told us, he spoke to his mother, and she goes, yes, you actually had some allergies when you were younger as well, and we don't know what it was. So it's not the first time he's ever had a reaction, but he just couldn't play with it against Montenegro 2 days ago. But thankfully, he's back and playing now. As you can see, he goes up strong and scores against Gutierrez.
Just so controlled, calculated. and then the outstanding finish. That's a great sign for Coach Roy Rana and the Egypt team.
And Jaime's helped up. He's been, we noticed before the game, he was doing a lot of exercises trying to limber up. He must be struggling a little bit physically.
Well, that's one of the challenges of the tournament, as you see Ibarra. I love the way Josh Ibarra has started this game, attacking the rim, strong to finish. There's the steal and three for Paul Stoll. But that's the challenge, game to game, the bumps and bruises, the competition.
Oh, what a shot from Paco Cruz. He was literally out of bounds and just has such a golden feel for the ball and the goal. He's shot over the backboard.
Outstanding.
Stoll comes up with the steal. Heron back to Stoll. Over to Heron, and that's his shot.
Really good offense there. Unselfish, good spacing from Mexico.
Look at that shot. That's not easy, is it?
No.
Well, for us mere mortals, but for Paco,
and again,
I come from the heavens, Cruz.
Yeah, he's right-handed on that side, right? If you're lefty, you have a little bit better angle. He's got a sharper angle. He shoots it over the edge of the backboard with a rainbow touch. Outstanding, Paco Cruz.
Nice drive for Ahab Amin, and timeout. So let's go down to the bench and listen up.
So impressive there. You see him getting to the rim. Mexico has had an issue in these games controlling the basketball, guarding the basketball one-on-one, and now there's no rim protection in there. Amin just right to the rim for the easy two. Let's see if the team from Mexico can rally coming out of this timeout, do a better job guarding the basketball and getting some defensive stops here. Amin, after the big game, already with 7 points here in the first quarter.
So the foul has been called, and push on Ahab Amin.
Lots of hand checking and holding from both teams here again. Omar Hussein called for the foul as Paco Cruz used the screen. Israel Gutierrez to the line. Mexico in the bonus.
Thank you. Here's Egypt. They're not missing right now. And here's Marai, and he gets it up and in.
Jeff, with that layup, they are now 10 for 12 here in the early going. Egypt has got to pick up their defensive work. Mexico has got to pick up their defensive work.
Stoll looks good. A little short. Gardner comes down with the ball. Well, we did see a lot of improvement, I felt like, from Egypt. And I think they're building, they're growing, but good hands from Paco Cruz to knock it away. Cedron misses the shot.
Just difficult for Heron to finish against that length right there from Gardner. Great challenge and defense from Gardner.
Amin knocks it down.
Jeff, 11 for 13.
And Ahab Amin, meanwhile, continues his scintillating pace here. He's got 9 points. He was without a doubt just on fire the other day against Montenegro.
Six seconds on the shot clock here for Mexico on the sideline.
Gonzalez has checked in, the under 19 basketball World Cup star. Cruz, and does not get it off in time. El Ghazawi. Funny, isn't it? Number one, El Ghazawi, played at the under 19 Basketball World Cup for Egypt. Led them in assist. Here he is now playing on the big stage of the main World Cup with the senior team.
Great for his future and Egypt's future development.
Oh, puts it up. It's not just about the assists for number one.
And you have to love a young player stepping in, playing with confidence.
Oh. And Paco Cruz with the floater.
No matter the ball pressure, no matter the physicality, Paco Cruz has been effective all three games. But you can see the difference, the ball pressure, physicality that Egypt's applying, and the difference. Mexico.
Here's Ahab Amin. Ogindi. Shot clock about to expire, and a reach, and they're going to count it. Gortieta is trying to stay with Gindi, and then Jaimes reached in. And wasn't too much of a foul there, but I think just reaching, sometimes you put yourself in jeopardy of getting that foul. And unless they called it on Gortieta. Oh, no, they called it on Gortieta.
The concerning part here for Mexico is, though, we've seen the other two games, Gindi struggled to beat people off the dribble and get to the rim, and here he is just getting in the paint for an and one.
Oh, Jeff. Boy, the ball goes off of Gutierrez. Al-Ghazawi puts it up. And just a very difficult, it feels like they've got a hangover from their performance. Mexico against Lithuania.
13 for 15 from the floor, 10 for 10 from two-point range. Again, outstanding first quarter for Egypt.
30 to 16, Egypt on top of Mexico at the end of one. Well, scanning the barcode to get Courtside 1891 into your smartphones for video streams, schedule scores, and more. It is what you need to have, especially during the FIBA Basketball World Cup, so do it now. Mike, listen, I mean, the Olympic qualifying tournament is still realistic for Mexico when you consider they're going to be 19 teams going to the OQTs from the World Cup. So the third best America's team gets a spot in the OQT for sure, and the rest is by ranking.
They have a lot to play for here, and let's hope they can have a better second quarter.
Oh, Jaimes goes up against El Ghazawi, and Gardner rebounds the miss. And, oh, good recovery that time. Ibarra, some rim protection finally from Mexico. Bounce pass, right idea, but maybe a little behind him. And the ball goes off of Marai and out of bounds. I mean, for Egypt, if one of the African teams does somehow sneak into the second round, well, then that team is going to have the advantage to get direct qualification for the Olympics.
And like you said.
But if they don't, yeah, and they win this game, then they're right back in it.
Yeah. But, you know, we've seen some really good things out of these African teams, the Asian teams. They're much improved. And I think that's just a great thing for basketball around the world.
But what's nice is, even though these teams don't have a chance here of going to the second round, these games still mean something.
Without a doubt.
Here's Gael Bonilla. Oh, we got Mexico just have struggled making their shots the last two games. Good hands, Gutierrez. Gardner into Marai. Gardner from the right. And he nails it. And that's the problem for opposing defenses. He can step outside in a very Tony Kukoc-like way, nail the three-pointer. You got to respect it.
And Gardner in this game in particular is a difficult matchup. You see, he's a tall, skilled, long four. Jaimes is the key four for Mexico. And they really have some non-mobile bigs coming off the bench.
It's impossible if you are here. He makes like this, and that is a contact. Is it possible? No. Okay.
So Amin pushes it quickly, and that was a little too much, but a reach and two free throws coming. Well, 2 points here. Ahab Amin played so hard against Montenegro. He came to the press conference after the game, but he was physically, you could see, struggling to walk. I mean, he had given everything, and you watch him play, he doesn't stop.
No, he looks great today, but you saw that he pushed the ball three-quarter length of the floor, and there was no resistance at all from Mexico. They've got to do a better job of stopping the ball, containing the ball, and keeping these guys out of the paint. Like, they're getting right to the rim for easy shots.
And the other thing that really bodes well for Egypt is, even though they lost their first two games against Lithuania and Montenegro, they fought for 40 minutes, and they had some really good phases of play, and they had the adversity of not having Asim Marai in that last game, yet they gave Montenegro everything they could handle. And I think you could see this, you know, it's made him stronger. Here he goes again, Ahab Amin. Look at him getting ahead, he gets it to Gardner! And they are just off to the races.
Really unselfish from Amin, the hustle to get to the ball. And then as he delivered it to Gardner, he kind of ran a traffic screen to give Gardner the runway to the rim.
They're playing with a lot of confidence, and right now, Mexico are in a crisis. And that's putting it mildly. We're in the 2 minutes into the second quarter, and they're trailing by 21 points.
Hey, vamos fácil en la ofensiva, güey. Okay. Hey, vamos lápiz y L, okay? Lápiz y L.
Don't worry about the last play. Hey, think the rim.
Hey, el tema es hay que correr para atrás. No están corriendo. Hey, y podemos jugar dos y ustedes dos. Hey, marchamos. Match up song. Okay? Te va un descanso, Paco. Hey, vamos duro, cabrones. Vale. Vamos.
So, Mike, just to talk about the Olympic qualification again, so you have 24 teams that will compete in the four Olympic qualifying tournaments as we look at these replays and this latest break by Egypt. And Ahab Amin getting it to Gardner, just sensational effort. So you've got 24 teams competing in the four FIBA Olympic qualifying tournaments. five of those teams have already earned their spots, because remember, we had pre-Olympic qualifying tournaments this summer. So you've got 19 more spots available here that are going to come from this World Cup. The highest placed team for each region of Africa, the Americas, Asia, Oceania, after the eight teams that directly qualify, will be awarded first, with the remaining spots going to the next 16 highest placed teams at the World Cup. So just to put that out there, here's Amin. And once again, it's a layup drill right now.
Out of a timeout, bad pass turnover. Amin with his energy. Again, you can just see the energy level of Egypt is just in a much better place than Mexico right now.
Gutierrez missing.
Beautiful.
And Zarhan. And another layup. I mean, they're making layups. Benilla, Ibarra.
Again, Mexico passing up a couple of rhythm shots there. Just not playing with a lot of confidence together right now.
Stoll and Jaimes are coming back in. Bonilla goes out. Gutierrez goes out. Here he goes again, Ahab Amin. I mean, the energy, the explosiveness, and it's all being triggered by number four right now. He is on fire. Ahab Amin, 15 points, 4 assists, 4 rebounds. And you gotta remember how well he played as well in that last game. I mean, he's leading them in scoring at 18 points per game. So that is the foul. We'll take anything they can get right now. Zarhan goes out, Gardner, Anas Mahmoud, and El Ghazawi come back in. So he had 26 points did Ahab Amin against Montenegro. He was 9 of 18 from the floor. Against Lithuania, he had 10 points. Here he is getting the rebound. Think he might get a triple-double today? Possibly.
Man, he's on pace right now, but most important is his energy level and his determination. He's playing, look at him just attacking.
That was good work from Paco Cruz. I think they might give the ball to Mexico. Oh, yeah, I think they're right. I don't think the referee saw the ball go off of Ibarra. That's what Ahab Amin was saying. But you're not going to get all the calls.
And it's a good decision from Roy Renna not to challenge it right now. Yeah. Save your challenge until later in the game.
I mean, it's already awfully difficult to see Mexico getting back into this one. This is just one-way traffic. They're being outscored 13-0 in the second quarter.
And it's just the effort level on the defensive side. Egypt is making Mexico work hard to get good shots, and they're just not hitting the ones that are there or working hard enough to get easier shots. We need more effort level on both ends of the floor from Mexico.
Orlando Mendez goes out. They have Amin. That was short. Paco Cruz drifts in and earns a trip to the line. I mean, Mike, it needs to be said. I mean, they have just been run out of the gym right now. But if you go back to game day one, when they played Montenegro, hey, they were right in the game. They were down 8 with about 5 minutes, just under 5 minutes remaining.
And this
had a chance.
This is why these first games are so critical to get that win. It puts you in a great position and gets the team feeling confident. The one thing that we've seen about Paco Cruz, no matter the circumstances and what the situations are, he's been attacking the basket and been productive. What the Mexican coaching staff, Omar Quintero, and his coaches are trying to do is they're trying to find a lineup and find players who can help cut into this deficit. It starts with hard work. It starts with energy. Paco Cruz is one of those guys.
Over to El Ghazawi. I see Marai. Hussein back to Anas. El Ghazawi. Wow. They're just flying right now, and it's even the youngsters.
Playing with so much confidence, a young player here, El Ghazawi.
18 years old.
Outstanding. Really great. Coach Rana giving him the confidence and opportunity.
Jaime's up to Ibarra for the dunk.
Ibarra has really come out here well in this first half. He showed some signs in that second half against Lithuania last game after a slow start.
Barra with the rebound. And the bounce pass to Ibarra. Well, I think he really, there's two things here with Egypt. I think as you look at the replay and Ibarra's going to get the line, that's a good call. Roy Rhino deserves a lot of credit. I mean, he's changed this program from Egypt. He's changed the attitude. Now, the players have responded. Because some players would have checked out coming into this game 0-2. Some teams would have. But Egypt have come in and played with a sense of urgency today. And I think that's because of the new way of Egypt.
Right. Roy's always done a great job with his players. Let's listen to his timeout here.
Guys, you did, right? Like, lots of time on the clock. You could have dunked it inside. You chose to take one, drive it, play to your strengths. Right, we're gambling for steel. Like, let's not start to relax, guys. Let's start to get undisciplined. Right? Come on, Rich. Stay locked in. And then again, against the zone, go get hard. Now we got one offensive rebound, we should be able to get more. Again, this trip, we're going fist down. You're the ball handler. Gindi and Hatem, four man, five man.
Again, we've seen some great timeouts from Coach Rana. He's teaching his guys. He's helping the young player, El Ghazawi, get out and really play with confidence. But they took this floor with determination today, Jeff. They've come out here and played with good energy. They've played together. A lot of that's the leadership of Amin. Marai coming back healthy is a positive boost for them. You know, but for me, when I look at this game, this is the challenge is these veteran Mexican guards that have got to do a better job guarding the ball, defending the ball for Mexico to have a chance to get back into the game. This is what it's all about. They're struggling to contain the ball. They're not stopping anybody in transition. And again, it's really hard to win on this level if you're not going to be able to defend.
So Ibarra's average and already just 1 point away from that. Well, it's a 24-point deficit. If they could start chipping away now, they could start playing the defense that you're talking about. Give themselves a chance. Gindi lets it go, and that was short.
There's a start, Jeff. Put some plays together for Mexico, as you say. Finish this first half strong.
Jaimes. Caron after the contact.
Great effort going to the boards. Just got him with the body a little bit, you can see here. Knocked Mariah out of there.
Well, El Ghazoui turns it over. So 25 remaining.
Sometimes for a young player, they get put in unique situations. The Mexican team changing defenses on them, a little full court trap, three-quarter court trap. And you see the sub, Musa back in. They'll get a chance to do that, show El Ghazoui some video on the situation and give him some more experience when he comes back in.
Cruz with a little floater. Little collision with SMRI and Geron.
Boy, both guys are a little banged up after that one.
Musa for three.
So again, Jeff, at the point of attacking these pick and rolls, there's too many times Mexican defenders are going under these screens, not fighting over, and Egypt is making them pay.
Parker Kurz for three. They don't want to just trade buckets, though. They got to continue to give the effort on the defensive end. They've cut it back to 22.
Here it is, you see the collision there, both Marai and Jerome. Boom.
I guess Marai's like, you know I'm there, you don't have to run into me. But here is Gardner. And Egypt already with 51 points. Ibarra, offensive rebound and putback.
I mean, it's been Paco Cruz and Josh Ibarra here in this first half for Mexico. Josh with a really good finish there.
That's a charge. Oh, that's a block.
Jeff. If I'm the official on the baseline, I'm probably calling a charge there.
Yeah.
It looked like he was solid. He was in position. Maybe the contact coming on an angle made it look like he was taking it on the side, but I felt like he took that contact pretty square. I'm sure the referees will review that one at halftime. But it's the third foul for Jerome here.
Well, he's going to sit down for the rest of the half. Gardner certainly has made an impact on this Egypt team. Guess they're glad he's a part of this program now.
For sure.
Cruz. Back outside. Good hands from Ahab Amin.
So Omar Hussein did an outstanding job of pressuring Paco Cruz there. Making him work, that's the type of defensive challenge that is going to help Egypt here continue to build on their lead.
Stole, they got to hurry. And not good awareness there for the clock. Here's Musa. And
Jeff, especially veteran players like Stoll and Cruz, these guys have to have better understanding and awareness of the situation. You know, Stoll had the chance to shoot, he passed it up, and then Cruz ends up just hoisting up a shot in desperation. I know that they'll hold themselves to a higher standard in terms of their execution than that possession right there.
Guys, again, right? If we're going to bring it here, it's only to get a logo pick and roll, and we got to take our time and get our spacing right. Okay? This trip down the floor, Patrick, awesome. You got the ball again. Adam, you're on one side. Omar, we're coming off. Shirt pin. Okay, got it. If the shot's not there, Manor zone. If it's not there, DHO back.
I'm cleaning up.
You're cleaning up. You're five balls.
And they press 2-2-1, I got the ball,
you stay. You know, what strikes me about the Egypt huddle is they're settled. There's a poise about them. They're all together. They're talking about the situations. Roy Rana saying, hey, if we get the ball here at the logo, meaning in between the three-point line and the block, it's a low pick and roll. He talked about the spacing. And then it went into the conversation from the team, the players talking about, hey, if they put this 1-2-2 press on us, I'm going to go here, be ready here. Again, they're settled, they're together, and that's a sign of a team that's connected and ready to play.
And those are some serious numbers for Ahab Amin. If he gets another assist, he'll be right on track for that triple-double.
And you called it first, Jeff.
Not that that's what he's thinking about, but Paco Cruz. One thing I've noticed with Roy Rana is I'm not sure I've ever heard him raise his voice.
He's very poised and calm. He got after the guys a couple times in one of the timeouts early.
Look at that. Foul. Three-point shot has been made, and there's also a foul. Wow. First of all, how good is Gardner?
Gardner's been really great the last two games, but here he is. He's scoring in the post. He's hitting the three.
And then Jaime's runs into Hassan Mirai.
He's complaining about a moving screen. Mirai was solid. And if anything, Mirai moved backwards. But again, for Mexico, you need to raise your effort defensively. You're screened too easily. You're beaten too easily. You're not stopping the ball early enough. It's too simple for them to get to the rim. This is a team defensive effort, team defensive situation that at this point, it's not good enough. They've got to defend better. They have to, you know, give up their body, be physical. We don't see that inspiring physical defensive play that's going to help them win. The hard thing to watch is this is a veteran team. They've had great success at different points in their careers.
Otis Jefferson in the house. There's Stoll. He's fouled by Musa. Shooting the three. Oh, that wasn't close. So he will go to the line. And from Mexico, it's been painful viewing.
You just work so hard to get to this point. You have high hopes for your team. And again, they have just not defended in these last two games on the level they need to.
Yeah. Egypt trying to turn the screw a little bit more. Their lead by 25 points against Mexico. Well, this might be his assist. And he gets it as Asim Marai scores with a turnaround jumper. So Ahab Amin has 15 points, 5 assists, 5 rebounds. Asim Marai, 7.7 rebounds. Here is Bonilla right at the end of the half.
And that's a good sign because he passed up some shots earlier. Stole with the late delivery and nice corner three from Bonilla. A little spark at the end of a tough half for Mexico.
Boy, was it ever. It has been one-way traffic.
Fair.
Complete domination. 59-35. Egypt on top of Mexico at halftime.
Josh Ibarra with a good start into the game, bouncing back from a tough matchup with Valanciunas in Lithuania, one of the bright spots from Mexico here in the first half. You can see finishing well at the rim, giving Mexico's offense something to rely on. It's been Josh and Paco Cruz. Jeff, this is your guy right here.
I'd say he has the inside track to the player of the game.
He's been the spark. He's been the catalyst. He gives his teammates a lot of confidence. Again, the pace and pressuring the rim has been really impressive. 15 points, 6 assists, 5 rebounds for your point guard. He's been a matchup challenge for this Mexican backcourt. But it's not only today. I mean, Marai with 7.7 rebounds in the first half, and also Patrick Gardner, 15 points and 5 rebounds. These three led by, I mean, look at all the green on that shot chart.
That's a lot of green.
So
just a smattering of red.
He needs to stop shooting from that right-hand wing spot where he's got the two misses. Just shoot from everywhere else.
So it's been a tough first half for Mexico. Somehow they've got to find something within themselves to rally here. And for Egypt, I mean, they just got an extra bounce in their step. So Mexico, it's just been really tough. I don't know what makes for harder viewing, the low shooting numbers or the fact that they've given up 59 points in the first half.
For me, it's the defensive point here. You know, you expect a better effort, especially in a winnable game, a tournament deciding game. And I think that, you know, to come out and dig a hole like this is really a challenge. But let's point to the really good half from Egypt. They played really well. They played with a lot of energy. Again, if you're Mexico, you like to see the start that Josh Ibarra had. You like to see what Paco Cruz has done. But in general, the team has to, you know, pay the price a little bit more on the defensive end.
Well, you think about the possibilities, especially for Egypt moving forward, and got a good nucleus of young players here. They've brought into the fold Patrick Gardner. mean, those numbers are just ridiculous.
They're outstanding. 16 for 18, 89% from two, 7 for 12, 58% from three, and 6 for 7 from the free throw line. Again, they're playing well, but they need a little bit more resistance.
Oh, so now he's got 6 assists. I thought we only had 5. It's
no.
Another one was
5 and 6.
Another one popped up. So, I mean, do you want to go tell him or shall I? Hey, Ahab, I know this is insignificant in the grand scheme of things, but
I think he's
you're going to make some headlines.
He's not as interested in numbers as he is in letters. He wants the W from today's game.
I think he wants the V.
V for victory.
Or T.
T for?
Triumph.
Triumph. That's next level.
Or S.
Success?
Yes.
Ooh. Right now, all of those things is the goal for Egypt. Let's hear what Roy Rana has to say.
They're going to try to rally Omar Quintero. Look at us. We're waving our hands. I'm next to the birthday boy, Mike Taylor. Happy birthday, Mike.
Thank you, Jeff. I appreciate it very much.
Did you get a pie in the face today by any chance?
I did. It's a Taylor tradition. All the players that have played for me through the years understand, family understands. And since your last name is Taylor, you know, you took care of business.
I delivered it.
A lot of fun. Really enjoying the time. Great tournament on the court.
Rondé Hollis-Jefferson on the left and Wissam Al-Sous, the coach of Jordan. Jefferson just with a spectacular performance yesterday. 39 points. He had a game-tying 4-point play. 10 seconds remaining. Scanning the barcode to get the FIBA Basketball World Cup app in your smartphone. Terrific app. Yeah, Hollis-Jefferson yesterday was, you know, I really like New Zealand, but I like Jordan as well. I felt bad for those guys when they left.
I mean,
they deserved something from that game.
The game could have gone either way. You see them putting their heart into it.
They, you know, I have been very impressed. This is the best Jordan team I've ever seen.
Yeah. Zone defense for the first possession here from Mexico.
Here's Patrick Gardner. And now, maybe this will be the start of a comeback from Mexico. And that's a good sign for Jaimes.
Great start, put some plays together. And if you're Omar Quintero, you want to see which of your players are going to really battle and compete.
Zarhan just floated in. I don't understand, there's no rim protection there from Ibarra.
Yeah, these are the multiple effort plays that you want to see if you want to cut into this lead.
Is he worried about picking up a foul? Is he thinking there was going to be a pass?
That's a great question.
There he is. I mean, he's okay in that on this end. But, yeah, I mean, we have seen him swat a shot or two.
He's got such a wide frame, uses his body well physically, and has nice touch. He's really a good passer out of the post as well. Right now, he's having his best game of the tournament here. 14 points and 2 rebounds.
Oh,
Again, Mexico in the 2-3 zone.
Been a fascinating World Cup, to be honest. Impressive crowd for this game as well. And there is a foul. Jaimes picks up the personal. His when he fouled out of the first game against Montenegro, that was a killer.
Yeah, that was
from
critical.
Mexico. Dauran. I'm not sure that's the shot they're looking for. Ooh. Cruz gets open, and there's Ibarra again. Oh, he needs to dunk that, Mike.
Yeah. So he got a great offensive rebound here in traffic. Tries to go up with the touch. Like you're saying, if you go up and try to dunk that ball, you have a chance to draw fouls. That's the type of physicality that is going to lead to success here, attacking the rim. So Roy Rana reacts to the zone coverage with Gendy, his captain, three-point shooter coming into the game.
Just looking over at Omar Quintero, and he just exactly told Ibarra to dunk that ball. And I'm pretty sure Stoll told him the same thing. They have a mean pass to Gardner. Another three-pointer for Gardner. Another assist for Ahab Amin. He's got seven. And a trip on Zahran for a block. He's saying it's a block. Let's have another look.
I really like Paco Cruz. He's been impressive in all three of these games. He can play pick and roll. He can play off screens.
Yeah, he clipped him on the back of his left heel.
And what I want to see from players, if you foul him, just say, hey, I fouled him.
Exactly.
Why are we complaining to referees constantly?
Like, why are we complaining when we're up 25 points on an obvious foul? Pedron saves it at bounds. Cruz feet set, and you can count that.
I mean, very good teamwork and hustle there from Mexico. Good ball movement. Paul Stoll penetrates, kicks it out. Cruz delivers. Let's see if they can get some defensive energy now after that three-point make.
Nice drive, Asim Marai. Ooh, good catch by Stoll. Jaimes. El Ghazawi. Ahab Amin. One more assist. And he's got his 15 points, 10 assists. So Geron is going to have to go out after picking up his fourth foul.
So now you have a matchup with Bonilla and El Ghazawi, two young players for your respective countries.
Good read by Jaimes. I think got a deflection, and then Ibarra came up with the basketball. There he is. Now he's going to go up strong. Much better. And now the steal and stole is off to the races. Passes it back to Gael Bonilla. And now it's Ahab Amin. So that was a missed opportunity for Mexico. It was just good hustle back, I guess, by Egypt. But now a turnover on El Ghazawi. And now the pass up to Bonilla over to Cruz. And that is another miss. So they will keep possession at this end. Oh, technical foul has been called on the Egypt bench for complaining.
But, you know, this is probably a result of the referees just having too much from constant complaints about fouls or calls,
well,
or situations before.
Mike, this just gets back to the point. I'm like, and we haven't seen this from Egypt in this tournament until now. And they've called the foul, technical foul on Rana. I thought it was because the players got up off the bench. So Stolen misses it. But anyway, I thought that was the biggest impediment to Egypt having some success before the Rana era, was they would tend to get drawn into it, some complaining and the whatever, and they're up 25 points and the complaining. Listen, just play.
Yeah, and again, you know, I've said this before, Jeff, the emotional discipline is really an important part of competing at a high level. Let's see if they can use that as a learning experience right there.
Jaime avoids the charge, battles for the ball, and Zarhan has it taken away, and there's the dunk that we were asking for from Ibarra.
And Jeff, you can see a difference in this Mexico team, more energy, more hustle, more defense this half, and they're playing much better. So really good response here early in the third quarter.
Yeah, that was Stoll that got a steal there. He's got two now. Jaime has a couple, and now Egypt have turned it over. And Roy Rana is going to call a timeout. And this is a good time for a timeout. You would have thought there was no chance that Mexico could get back in this game from what we watched in the first when they were out on the court. But they got a little bit of life. They're outscoring Egypt 11-7 in the third.
Get the loose ball, control it, right? We're on a race to score again now. I want to score. Just grab it, control it. Don't put it on the floor. Got it? Hey, defensively, like, it's all turnovers. Just settle down and talk. Now we know which goal we're strong in. Okay, so let's make sure we keep it to the right hand, okay? And then you gotta be there early and give up your body. You had a charge attempt, you didn't give up, you didn't go down. Take the charge.
Don't get out the way on that roll.
All right?
Thank you.
Let's go. Actually, I have to go, Patrick.
Jam the move, jam the move.
Well, basketball is a 40-minute game, and for that reason, Egypt has still got some work to do. Look at Stoll coming up and getting the steal and finding Ibarra for the dunk.
The one thing about these Mexican players, the veterans, they got a lot of pride. You know, they haven't played like they wanted to or their best to this point, and they've got a positive response. The hard thing for a team with a lead is being consistent. You can see how momentum can go the other way so quickly.
Ibarra takes a seat. He's got 18 points. Surely he'll want to get back in the game as quickly as possible. Here goes Ahab Amin putting it up, and that was a slap from Stoll, which puts Ahab Amin on the line.
Jeff, do you like Amin's shoes?
Oh, I didn't even notice. They look like space shoes. And again, the president of the Egyptian Basketball Federation looking on and seem to be quite pleased. Unless you forgot who that was, it's Magni Abufreka. Stole. Back to Cruz. Oh. And Zarhan just took it right away. And Zarhan just sailed in for the layup. Zarhan's got a little bit of nastiness to his game.
Yeah,
doesn't
he's
he? But
physical,
I like it.
Competitive. He's kind of in your face type guy.
Yeah.
Compliments the other skillful players on their team well.
The lead back to 24. Hey, una tres, una tres.
Vamos tres, tres abajo, okay? Irra, Paco, Gael, Fabián, okay? Se la vamos a Irra. Te metes, Paco.
Va a poner una buena,
sales. Hey, doble salida al mismo tiempo los dos. Hey, y si la agarras, ve y ataca duro la canasta, okay? Sale, cabrones, y hay que defender. Estamos en dos. Dale.
Gardner has been terrific tonight. 18 points, 6 assists. He can hurt you inside, he can hurt you outside.
His length and his versatility have been very impressive.
Yeah, I like his length and I like his strength.
His shooting touch has been impressive. And you know, it's always interesting to see.
Look at his energy tracker as well. A total of 20-26. Went on the court, plus 19. He's at, so that just goes to show you his value to the team. Anas Mahmoud back in the game. Paco Cruz floats in, and the thing, when you kind of make a run, it's awfully difficult to catch up, and I think Mexico have been reminded of that because Egypt have come right back to take a run, and now Paco Cruz floats in.
Great finish by Cruz. He was upset. He didn't get a call on the last floater on the baseline, but he kept playing. They got the rebound, good ball ahead, and Cruz finished that one.
Ahab Amin. There's Paul Stoll. And a foul down. Foul called on Mexico on Israel Gutierrez with a push.
The question I have on that situation was, it was a non-factor in the play. It looked like the ball was bouncing to the other side.
Gutierrez is trying to get an explanation from the Venezuelan referee. So here he is, Asamurai, back after the allergic issue. 10 points. With that make, he's also got 9 rebounds. You just know that every single game with Asamurai, he's going to show up and give you a solid performance.
And he's a guy that can score in the post and help you control the tempo.
Doesn't always make his free throws. They have Amin going for the steal. Ball goes behind his back, back to Paco Cruz. Boy, that is excellent offense.
Really good teamwork. Stoll, creative, gets in the gap, draws the help, makes the extra pass, and again, Cruz delivering 19 points on the game.
The D from Jaimes on Anas. They had Anas trapped. He's able to pass it. And the shot clock goes off. So one of the best defensive possessions for Mexico.
Yeah, the multiple efforts, the activity. You know, they needed this much earlier in the game to prevent themselves from falling in such a hole. But the encouraging thing is they've responded well here in the third quarter. And now can they trim this deficit here in the last 2 minutes and 37 seconds?
And Mike, it can't be a defensive possession, can it? It's defensive stands. Because if it's possession, then they have some, they have the ball.
Well, it is a possession where you're on the defensive side.
Okay.
But I understand the meaning of possession, of having the ball, is impossible when you're on defense. But it's funny because that's the terminology, right?
I was the one that said it, and it just made me think, wait a minute, what's going on here? That doesn't make sense. Stole for who the bell? It doesn't stole that time. And Ahab Amin brings it back up the floor. He's got 17 points, 9 assists, 5 rebounds. Patrick Garner goes in and misses the tough shot. Here's Stoll. And Stoll gets it to Bonilla, and he is fouled by Omar Hushain. Here it is again. Well, spoiler alert, but I think it's relevant for Egypt fans. The Dominican Republic have held on, and that is the best way to put it, to beat Angola, which means Angola will not go to the second round. So far, there's still no team going from Africa to the second round. It's still possible.
And Jeff, that was a great transition. Bonilla really ran the floor as he went into the basket. He was bodied up and fouled, and his legs got kind of tangled up. He landed on his tailbone. Good to see him walk off the court, but Moises Andriassi, the shooter, checks in off the bench cold, but he got his shots up towards the end of the game last night.
Yeah,
the other night.
I remember you saying that. Hopefully Bonilla is going to be okay.
Great to see him knock that one down.
But the reason why I say that about Angola not going to the second round, because Egypt's still in contention for the best African team, which would be direct qualification for the Olympics. Varane. And Gutierrez is not able to get it back. Ahab Amin right at the end of the shot clock. Great try by Zarhan. He saw it the whole way. He had the wherewithal to know that he had to get it up quickly, but he still missed.
So, shot clock violations here in the last minute.
Well, Andreazzi didn't. Oh, here's Jaime. So he gets loose. He comes in for the dunk.
Really nice play here from Mexico. The last play we had Stoll coming out for a handoff. Now he sets the small, big traffic screen. Jaime's right to the rim. Nice job from Omar Quintero there with play design.
Omar Hushain drives in and one. I think he just mouthed the words, and one. So we're going to get a challenge here from Omar Quintero because he believes the leg, I think he's thinking that there was a foul committed. He's going to challenge the foul call. I'm not sure he could challenge the foul call, can you? But he's...
I think he's saying that he kicked...
Let's listen to the refs.
He's just protecting himself. I didn't see he extend the right. Okay? He's just protecting, that's all. He's protecting and that's all. But he's coming from the from one point to the point of the other player, and he's not leaving his cylinder, okay? Let me. Ah, he's jumping vertical. He's jumping vertical. Yeah? That's great. So nothing, go say nothing. Sorry. No more foul, one free throw there, nothing.
So he was thinking that Omar Hussein had kicked Paco Cruz intentionally here.
Well, he did kick him, but I don't think there was any intent there. He's just athletically going to the basket.
Yeah.
There's no, like, his eyes and focus is all on the rim there.
I mean, I don't want to cast aspersions on a player, but let's just put it this way. I'm not thinking 100% along those lines. I'm leaving open a slight possibility that maybe, but maybe I'm wrong. But, I mean, the referees didn't hesitate. They saw it and they said it was a clean play. So.
But I think if he had intent to do it, he would be, like, trying to target. He would have to look back at least a split second.
It wouldn't make sense for him to do it, would it?
No. Yeah. He's trying to get to the rim, and he's a physical player.
I guess what I'm saying, he just got him square right where it hurts.
And now we have a challenge from Egypt. Let's use our challenges before the fourth quarter starts today right here.
Okay. Let's do it. Let's use them in the space of 10 seconds.
Leave me this master camera. Wait, I will touch. Wait. The moment of the contact is this, okay? So we have this, and we have... So this is the white, touch it. The white, and then the green, okay? Yeah. So we have... Wait. Andres, I'm moving. So we have first white, and then the green. The one who can see is this.
Yeah. Go back.
So we have white.
White.
Green. And green.
Yeah.
Okay? White, and then we have the green.
Green, yeah?
So we have the time also. It's okay, it's correct. So we correct the initial decision we give with the white ball, okay? Conclusive, yeah?
Yeah.
White ball, okay? So in that way, yeah, I will.
White ball.
That's why Roy Rana challenged. And they looked at it and determined. They went off of Mexico. They have Amin from deep. Get an offensive rebound for Asamurai. He's got a double-double now, 10 points, 10 rebounds. And here's Murai again. He gets fouled going up by Jaimes.
So last game, he had an allergy. Now he's got a headache on that finish.
He's definitely been kind of had a couple of exchanges with Jaimes. Oh. You might remember they collided once when, oh. I mean, that was a hard foul on the face. You just have to be tough, don't you?
Yeah.
To play this sport.
And what people don't really appreciate is the physicality of the international game, especially here at the World Cup. The best players have a physical element to them. The game has a physical element to it.
And Jaimes comes in and scores a little floater.
They went back to their small, big traffic action. Guarded differently, Stoll gave the ball right back to Jaimes and a nice finish.
They have Amin, just blocked. Traveling on Ahab Amin. Paco Cruz, hand in the face. Good job by Ahab Amin. Although I thought he was flirting with a foul there. And Egypt head over to the bench, leading it 77-56 over Mexico with 10 minutes remaining.
I was actually looking at my app, Courtside 1891, and then I got a pie in my face.
Let's just clarify that. 17 points, 9 assists, 5 rebounds for Ahab Amin. It's your birthday, Mike. And yes. What happens on your birthday?
Well, I was enjoying a nice face. Lunch, looking at my, you know, World Cup stats and statistics.
You were having some Philippine food today.
Yes, pancit was very good.
Cruz missing. And the rebound for Ahab Amin, that is his first rebound in the second half. He's got 17. He's just 4 rebounds and 1 assist shy of a triple-double. Mike, the people are friendly in the Philippines, aren't they?
Oh, it's been wonderful. Everybody very friendly, respectful, you know, and they love basketball.
They do. They love you, Mike. I've seen them. The way they celebrate your birthday today. Stoll comes out and misses.
I think you did a great job organizing the background, and I think they supported you.
They do like me.
Yeah. That was definitely teamwork right there, I'll tell you.
I can see Hector Hernandez, the Mexico international in the stands watching. He was the last cut from this team. I don't know if he came along just in case there was an injury or if that was a tough decision, but it must be difficult for him watching this, knowing that maybe he could have helped this Mexico team, which is down by 21 points. Here's Ahab Amin. Wow, what a shot. He wanted to pass.
Yeah, like when it's going your way, it's going your way. He left his feet, tried to drop it off to Marai, and just flung it up there. Money in the bank.
Paco Cruz, beautiful play. Ibarra. Gael Bonilla back in the game. Seems to be okay. Oh, nice pass, Bonilla, to Jaimes.
Jaimes has made some nice plays with active cutting here. Bonilla dropped it off to him. You almost expected him to throw it out to Ibarra, who was stepping to the open area, but the basket cut was a great find.
Oh. Jaimes commits the foul. And that's just not a foul that he needs to make.
No, just unnecessary. It's fourth.
He fouled out the other day, and you're not, you know. Okay, reach in and try to knock it away, but don't put your hands around him or your arms.
Oh,
what a play. He's got 20. Patrick Gardner.
Just right over the top of Jaimes. Couldn't get up there. The length, a factor for Gardner.
Amin. Ahab Amin picks up the foul. He's got 3 fouls. Don't need to be bringing him out now, Roy. He's close to the triple-double. Here is Bonilla, and again, Ahab Amin. So he fouled Jaimes. Oh, he's going to sit down. That's going to hurt his prospects of a triple-double.
But it's going to help his prospects as the tournament develops and goes on. We don't want to wear guys out and give them too much of a workload only for a triple-double.
The fans do.
Well, you're probably right.
Stoll from the corner. That's nice.
So we've seen Stoll make great passes to Cruz for 3. This time, Cruz returns the favor to Stoll.
And here to Marai. Great work by Patrick Gardner.
So when teams pick up full court and extend their defense, the concept is smart pressure. When you over pressure and lose containment, you give the other team a transition opportunity. And that was a great pass from Gardner and Mirai gets the easy finish at the rim. So smart pressure needed as teams extend their defense.
And Samurai does not get that to drop. Nice play, Paco Cruz. Patrick Gardner. Musa, who's just started his master's in business analytics at Tarleton while he's been here in Manila, which means I guess he's doing it because of the internet, he's able to do it. I guess he has to hear his lectures and what have you.
Who is currently coaching college basketball at Tarleton State?
I don't know. Who is it? You know?
My guess would be former University of Kentucky coach Billy Gillespie.
No kidding.
We can ask Mr. Google at one of these timeouts.
You're right, Billy Gillespie, Tarleton State.
Have you ever been to Tarleton State?
That's in Stephenville, Texas. No, I haven't.
I have been to a junior college recruiting showcase at Tarleton State many, many seasons ago.
Well, that's where Adam Musa is going to play, I believe.
I've also coached a player whose birthday was yesterday, Ed Williams, who played at North Carolina Wilmington and Tarleton State.
Nice. Gendy gets blocked. You know how you have a telegraphed pass and it gets intercepted? That was a telegraphed shot.
And it got blocked.
And it got blocked. Look at this.
Great play from Bonilla. Again, you know, as a young player, we've seen some good things from Bonilla.
Oh, and speaking of the devil, here he goes. Look at that.
Hey, great job. The length, playing the passing lane, deflections, activity on D.
They may have to get a timeout here. And Cruz commits the foul.
But again, look at Cruz, the veteran player. He fouls him, and maybe inadvertent contact. But as we see, look at this great steal and transition finish. The length, great. But Cruz raised his hand. I fouled him.
Look at that. Anticipation. He's hunting.
Anticipation,
hunting for a steal.
Acceleration.
And that Mexican fan just happy to see the steal and the bucket. That's a Mirai. Takes it deep. And now Paul Stoll has just been teed up.
I love Paul Stoll. Veteran player, great guy, but he fouled him there, Jeff. You know, a lot of pride, a lot of frustration here. Paul has been really successful in his career, different stops, won some championships, been a part of some really good teams.
So Mexico over the limit, so he gets two free throws and the technical free throw. Now he's got four fouls. Feels like the Mall of Asia air conditioning system's working just fine. It's blowing right away here.
And one of
the winter coat.
Jeff, you helped me tremendously in our time together. And one of the greatest pieces of advice that you ever gave me was, Mike, it doesn't matter how warm or hot it is outside. bring a jacket to these arenas.
Yeah.
So here we are.
In need of a...
Well, I'm thankful I have my jacket today.
They don't call you Mike Shivering Taylor for nothing. There goes Mariah. He has to go out of the game. Got a cut. Well, he's had his issues, hasn't he? He's had the allergy. He's got a cut. And, you know, he's been on the receiving end of some physical play, I have to say. I can see why he's been a little bit, shall we say, perturbed.
Banged up. He's been banged up. But
he's definitely been getting, yeah.
We say that's what it takes, giving up your body. You've got to give up your body to set a screen. You've got to give up your body to defend. You've got to give up your body to win position. And he's done it for this Egypt team.
Gardner out, Anas Mahmoud back in the game. Oh. Right idea, but too much zip on the ball?
Yeah, I mean, that's, if you know Josh, he'll put some zip on those passes, and that was it. Bonilla with an active cut. You can see Josh looking for him. He just fired it too hard. The key about passing is knowing who your receiver is and making it a catchable pass.
They have a mean, the lob, and there he's got his 10th assist.
But even against Vucevic from Montenegro, you know, Mohammed got behind the big, and he can play above the rim. That was a great pass from Amin.
Paco Cruz missing. Chance to run. Zarhan goes in for the layup. 19 points, 10 assists. You can see for Ahab, Amin, and Zarhan back to his best. He's got 12 points, flying high once again for Egypt. Timeout Mexico. Let's go down and listen. There's the beautiful pass for the 10th assist from Amin. You see him just getting into the lane. Drew the help from Ibarra, and there's the above the rim finish from Mohammed. Powerful move. Well, overall, Ibarra, on the offensive end especially, has shown what he can do in this game. Has shown what he can do. He didn't see it yesterday or 2 days ago, but today we have.
Well, we saw a better response in the second half against Lithuania, but here again you saw Paco Cruz with the playmaking. Nice pocket pass, and Josh finishing strong.
Still a 22-point lead for Egypt. Ooh, strong rebound from Gael Benia. Look at Ahab Amin almost getting a steal. For whom the ball Stoles.
I mean, that was outstanding body control from Paul Stoll. He took the pressure and then drove, got the defender leaning, and then decelerated for the nice bank shot. Nice play, Paul Stoll.
Did you like what I did for that?
I do.
Doesn't even need to be commented on.
No, it's just...
Oh, alley-oop pass to Anas.
You know, yesterday with Wetzel Pretzel, today with For Whom the Ball Stoles. You know, you're in top form out here.
Look at Zarhan again! And Jero, oh, traveling on Zarhan.
Take a look here, Jeff. One, two.
Here's Gindi with the lob to Anas. Who knows what to do with it, but he wasn't able to dunk it.
You like the way Ibarra tried to hammer that ball.
And Gindi misses. Andreassi. Oh, what a pass that was.
And you can see Paul Stoll, crafty playmaker, experience. No look, dropped it off pocket pass. Again, Ibarra has done a great job diving to the rim today. You can tell those guys have played a lot of possessions together.
Why don't you explain to our viewers specifically the pocket pass reference?
So when defenders guard a pick and roll, there is a pocket between the ball handler's defender and the big man's defender. And it usually happens at the point of attack initially. It comes at different angles because of the way the coverages are set, but it's, you a lot of times see the guards throw a low bounce pass below the knee level, and it just slips right in between the two defenders to the big, and that was an example of a great no-look pocket pass from Stoll to Ibarra.
Amin! Ahab Amin, 22 points, 10 assists, and 6 rebounds. But it doesn't look like he's going to get his triple double. Only just one rebound in the second half.
Coach Rana congratulating Amin, subbing out there, encouraging him.
He's responded. Who's back in the game? Well, it's going to be interesting to see how Egypt perform the rest of this tournament.
See if this is a confidence-building win for them.
Oh, it very definitely, as my U.S. history coach used to say in high school, will be. Very definitely. I don't think you really need to say that, do you?
It very definitely will be.
It definitely will be.
Yes. But it's not just definitely.
That's just a little bit of emphasis.
Extra emphasis. It very, very definitely will be a confidence-building win, and they have played really well together today, Jeff. Credit to Coach Rana and his team. They have controlled this game. They've got good production.
Musa on the baseline. Zahran with the offensive rebound to put back. Well, Mike, I mean, primarily the damage for Egypt was done in the first half.
Yeah, again, you know, you're in a winnable game for both teams. It's a tournament-defining game, and they really came out the right way.
Here's a lob for you, Gindi. Egypt showing the best version of themselves today.
Sub,
What you really see from the young guys, like Zarhan, I still consider Ahab young, is a lot of emotion.
Yeah, I mean, they finally have a way to channel their positive energy into a team. You know, Roy Rana brings positive structure here. He brings coaching. He gives them a system. He gives them coaching points. And this is probably what these guys have been craving for years. They want to be a part of a successful team. They want to learn how to play and how to play together and win on this level. So these are so many positive things happening for this Egyptian national team.
Well, here's Musa at short. Hebron, oh, just rejected by coming off the bench, Al-Gawadi and Abdel-Gawad, excuse me. And there is another foul. So they've got their 100, Egypt. They've hit the century mark. It's going to be a good team dinner tonight. Something to cheer about. Look at that, 22 points, 6 rebounds, 10 assists, 2 steals. Stoll's fouled out. And Paul Stoll had 11 points, 13 assists, 4 steals. And that's how it finishes. And Egypt, they're not going to the second round, but they are on a positive path right now. We've been saying that after all of their games, and that positivity was positively seen today as they came out and rolled to a big win over Mexico. 100-72, Egypt get their first win here at the FIBA Basketball World Cup. And it'll be back to the drawing board for Mexico, and I don't know what will be said in the changing room and the locker room, but tough game today for the 12 Warriors. So, some people think these games don't mean anything, but they mean a lot, considering what's at stake for Egypt in terms of Olympics possibilities and rankings points and national pride, but also, you know, the fact that they are in effectively a new way of doing things, a new program, and they are reaping the fruits. Is that right?
Yeah.
Reaping the benefits.
Reaping the benefit. This
the hard work.
This is, you know, the mainstream. This is the world stage. So every opportunity to get a win is something special. And, you know, what I love about the World Cup, I've said it before, is teams from all over the world bring different styles, different cultures to these games. And it's wonderful to see the development in some of these national teams making steps forward. And this is an example here with Roy Rana and his Egypt team. They really deserve this win. They played very, very good team basketball. And again, we've seen it coming the last couple games. They just had some tough losses. It's a challenge for them. And today they get over the hump and get a big win. You have to respect it, and you see how happy they are. It's a nice moment for Egypt and their national team.
Well, if you want to see the best plays from the fourth quarter, keep watching. Amin thought about passing it, decided to shoot it. Daryl Bonilla
came out and started making some good plays. Got the ball to Jaimes. And Patrick Gardner really showed some nice play today.
Yeah, he was excellent. I think the key was Amin. Gardner was right there with him. And then after that, you know, Asen Marai was very good. But, you know, they have a team. They're playing to their roles. They've just done a really good job out here today. Credit to Egypt. Nice win.
This was Amin with the lob to Anas. Zarhan coming out and really getting after it. And these guys, you know, it's frustrating when you play well in long phases like they have at this tournament against, you know, teams that are just that little bit better than you, and you don't get the wins, and you just want to get a win. And they just came out today and said, we are not losing this game today.
Yeah, they had the right energy level from the beginning. They established their defense with ball pressure, with multiple efforts. They dominated rebounds 41-23.